So where are we weak on transit? I need to do my I mean all this side, all the west side of the city is completely disconnected. I'll need to do something about that. Something going down this arterial. I'll probably call it the Western Express. It's just going to go up and down this arterial in a clockwise and counterclockwise. Let's add that on while I'm thinking about it. We'll take this all the way back down. I mean, does this actually count as a circular? I don't think it really does. What do I want to call this one? It's a brown one. What is that commercial district? What shall we call it? End Center. We'll call it the End Center. The end center, which stands for next, but we'll not go that. the end center to Industry Express. Okay, these people have got pretty decent walking routes, I think. We've had a nice habit of putting loads of paths in here, so I don't think we need to worry about circular pathing too much. Emperor Akihito turns 89 BC, making him the longest lived Japanese emperor. I mean, a lot of these monarchs have got a really long life, haven't they? Suppose once you get that tip top healthcare, you know. Alright, I'll just call this Industry Circular. Industry Circular clockwise, and we'll put the opposite direction in. Oh. Industry, circular, counterclockwise. Yeah, we've got plenty of bus routes. Sort of cover. We've got this. I mean, people can walk up and down, I hope, to the bus stops to get into the industry area. The bus line's going up here. Bus line's covering this lot. Brings them all back to this area if I want to start messing on. Right. Metro line. This one. Central line. Did I do counterclockwise there? I think I did. Cool. Need this one. Central line clockwise. Just hits all of these stops. Create a new line. Does this end here? No, it comes all the way up. Up and then back. Cool. And we'll just call that one we'll call this one circular, actually. Circular. Circular, and this one can just be central line. Central line just comes up and down. Okie dokie, and the final one we need is the line taking us to the industrial area. This one. Add stop. Line, and we'll just call that one the Industry Express. IX Industry Express. Cool. So transit. Would you say that that's the transit bit done? I'm so happy that Ursula popped out of the house after that case. because what had happened is last week Tasha got the game Dreamlight Valley on launch, and she was playing it religiously after work, pretty much every day. So she sunk about 10 to 15 hours in, would you say, Tasha, before you got to a quest called Curse, which, if you come across that quest, good luck. But what had happened is, spoilers if you're playing Dreamlight Valley, that quest requires that both Ursula and Merlin be out of their houses and available to talk to progress that quest line. But the problem with the quest line is it locks all the characters in their homes, so you can't get to them. And that's not such a problem with Tasha now, because Ursula and Merlin are tagged as important, so they don't get locked in the house. But there's a second part of that where the characters need to be, you need to be able to talk to them as well. But Tasha had another quest for Ursula already open, which is building her house, which required you to go into all the other characters' homes and get some items for them. But all those items were locked in the houses and you couldn't get in. So the problem Tasha had was that she couldn't complete Ursula's quest line to get her to talk about this new quest line, so she hard locked the game, which is a massive oversight, I think, and which is why I was frustrated. and I think it should have been, that should never have got through playtesting at all. So it was a pretty substantial problem with the quest chain, which meant that Tasha had to just restart the game again. I raised a ticket with the developers of the game, and they just said they're going to give us 25 dream shards or whatever, which doesn't resolve the problem. But Tasha had to restart the game from scratch, just bin off the 15 hours or whatever she put in the game and do it all again. But on this weekend, where we've not really been doing much of anything, Tasha's been playing it for... She's caught up to where she was and she started getting a bit further on. So we're talking probably about 9 hours each day. You're probably pushing 20 hours now. Maybe even into the mid-20s hours of gameplay there. So if Tasha had to rive it off again, I think that would have caused a lot of heartbreak. Because you're talking 20 hours. Because we don't really have any weekends, we're talking, it took Tasha days and days to catch up. To a point where it's one of those where, do I even want to play it anymore? If I'm just going to have to keep fighting these bugs. And the answer there is unequivocally going to be no. Right, okay, how are we doing? Let's fill this up, shall we? With some low density residential. There we go. How's our transit looking now? Bottom left has got nothing going for it. Lots of people using the buses, actually. I'm really impressed, to be honest. Alright, so what's the most popular line? The North East Circular. That takes you to the harbour. So that's popular. The Southwest Circular, which takes you to the stadium. The Northwest Circular. North East is very popular. I think that's because a lot of people are coming in via the harbour, ain't it? Not for circular. The southern ones, they're still getting a lot of use. I'm really impressed this route up and down isn't really getting much use. It just spiked up there, actually, which is good. The industry circular, these people don't really want to use the buses. I'm gathering through walking distance to work. And the other way around. So they're getting some use, but not a lot of use. Good, so industry stable now. We're not having problems with not enough products to sell. Garbage processing could be better. Don't have any more room here for more garbage stuff. Whoa, why is the train getting held up by garbage trucks? Number one on things that should never happen. Junctions. Stop. I just rode. There we go. Should probably build another road connecting up to this, to be honest. Which I think I will. There you go. So let's see if that yields any better results for them. Right, garbage processing. I need to be careful here, because this is a residential building. It's going to start getting very ill. I probably need to convert this to a bit of commercial. Or maybe some offices. We are holding out for some industry. And there's a railway going through there. There we go. This area is gonna be stanky. Highly educated workers around here, that's a problem. No one wants to work here. I think it's because there's also a lack of residential around here as well, which might get sorted out if I build some residential around here. Tasha completed the curse! You go, Tasha. I'm so proud. Alright, industry. We're still building up that residential count. I don't think we need to build any more residential, you know. I think we'll get to 75 on what we've got. So what I'm going to do is, there is this nice vein here of ore. I'm just going to build a dirt road around all this. Do I not have access to dirt roads anymore? Oh no, I've selected the damn thing. So I'm just gonna... build a little... do I live in England? I do indeed live in England. The northeast of England, to be precise. Do I have a cat that wants attention?
Hello. What's the matter with you, eh?
It's a year. Yeah, yes, I do live in England. I live in the northeast of England. I've lived here all my life. Well, not the northeast. I was originally born more centrally, but yes, indeed. Road guidelines, man, they're a bit of a pain sometimes. Also, doesn't have that road anarchy still on. It's probably playing havoc. Alright, so what I'm gonna do is in. I'm going to district this up. Where's my district button? Behold. Make sure I've got all this covered. Because you know what I'm like, I'll forget to do this and I'll have general industry. And this is going to be our industry. And for the moment being, I'm just going to fill this in. Man, the road tool today has been really funny. Oh, it's because I'm on curve, not freeform. know. Getting power across here. Damn. oh, here we go. And I say, like, I couldn't connect it up to the main industry area because... the road's too thick. There we go. Let's see if that helps. Sewage treatment's at an all-time low. Probably need to keep an eye on that. There we go. Bit of industry that handles ore. Stop. Don't know why all these are traffic light controlled. I've not really been maintaining this that well, have I? But I might have committed a cardinal sin here, because this industry traffic's going to go through the residential area. Right, it's going to come from down here. To an extent, it's going to cut through the commercial district. But we'll see if it causes any problems. If it does, I'll just create these roads here so they come into this little area here. See if that makes any difference. Alrighty. It's now literally just becoming a balancing act between my RCI. I think the rest of it will look after itself. How's traffic doing? 81%. I'm still impressed with how traffic's gone through the city. This has always been a concern of mine with these games, is traffic. European railways are characterized by low platforms. Therefore, there are steps inside the train. And the inside of a train in Japan is flat. I prefer that way. I prefer having such a flat entryway onto a train. Or any public transport. But yes, the trains in the UK do have a pretty hefty step up onto the train. And the way they get around it is they have attendants, which you can ask for at platforms, who pull out a little platform, which essentially acts as a slope to get onto the train. But I always prefer a flat loading. Like, they tried doing that in the UK with buses, actually. So, British curbs are normally about yay high. And for the longest time, buses used to have, like, three steps to get onto them. Because, like, they sat quite high was a seating area. But as European design, I think what European designs started moving forward, they... had a flat loading area. I say loading area, entrance to the bus on the front door, which also just remained one single level towards the back of a bus, which eventually you had to have to step up because the engine was back there. But the first few rows of seating were all on one level, and the buses, when they pulled up to the curb, they had a hydraulic system which lowered the bus down so it came level with the curb, which I thought was really cool. But of course, with stuff like infrastructure in particular, bus stops getting put in really stupid places where curbs aren't that high, it only works in certain places and not everywhere. All I see here, fellas, is a load of boxes. It's a big garbage problem down here. I don't... Despite there being garbage trucks down here, it's getting kind of irksome. What's going on here? Lack of goods or... Huh! No one wants to work at the best of best shoppies. This is winding me up having this message here. Is there a way I can road anarchy this into silence? There we go. Watch all the traffic start coming down here to turn around. That'll be funny. The Limited Express Azumas made in Japan. I've been on an Azuma train. They use them on the LNER, which is our main railway from London to Edinburgh and Glasgow. It goes all the way up the east side of the country. But I've been on the Azumas. Very good trains. The older trains used to have comfier seating in first class, like wider seats, like leather, a bit more reclined to them. Whereas the Azumas, even in first class, they still feel quiet. You know, like you're nudging shoulders with the person next to you. But they are very comfortable, very quiet, and very smooth. Like the old trains, you got buffeted about like this. But I can't fault the Azuma trains beyond just the first class seating be a little bit less comfortable than what it used to be. How are we going here? Is this just educate more citizens? Okie dokie. It's eventually going to come down to land value around here because I've built zero parks around here. Well, actually, I've built some up here. Right, eventually it's going to come down to land value, so I'll build a few parks. Yeah, that's made a lot of people happy. Okay, there we go, that's fine. I only 5,000 more, and then we have our megalopolis. Actually, we didn't even buy our last tile. I don't even know which one to unlock. They're just for sanity's sake. Or they're so I can expand industry if I need to. Although industry's expanding up here anyway. So happy with how this city's turned out. I'm like, before, this is the first city I've ever gotten this far in City Skylines. Before, I always used to struggle with traffic to a certain extent because I didn't really apply city building fundamentals that I learned from City Planner Plays. The most important one being road hierarchy, and that's where you've heard me start talk about arterials and collectors and local roads. The idea being that you don't have arterials connecting to local roads apart from extreme circumstances. So you see here my main arterial is going through the city is this one, which goes up here. You see there's not a lot of roads connecting to it. It connects up to this collector, and then it terminates here where it connects to this arterial slash collector mindless concoction I have here. Let me come back. I have another arterial which goes through the center of the city. It has this little interchange here which connects to collectors. Again, connects to these collectors. And then terminates at this weird concoction thing here. But the point being with these arterials, which come through the city, they only connect to collectors. I don't put any local roads near them. And these collectors are The high capacity roads, which connect to local roads, which have all your residential stuff on there. The point being that traffic from your local roads goes to a collector, and then if it wants to go further afield, it can access a arterial. And I must say, it's worked very well for this city. I've not had much of a problem with traffic, sans when I've been doing the buses, which is just flowing so nicely now. I mean, the road hierarchy system got a little bit funny down here, to an extent. Like, it's pretty much collectors connecting to collectors at this point. But that's okay, because this community's got access to this, these collectors, which take you eventually to the arterial. So I'm really good. Although we have our problems with industry, but I think that's just city building games in general. The industry area always causes a massive pain. And that's something that I also learned from City Partner Plays, is that you should never, never let your industry traffic go through residential areas. So I've tried to keep that in mind and made sure that if you look at the main road that comes into the industry area, it doesn't actually go for any residential areas. It just comes down this arterial, then down this arterial to get in and out of the city. And I've also expanded that by giving it a freeway connection, which also doesn't go through any residential areas, obviously. But this cargo plant's caused a bit of havoc. Right, well, our population growth's dropping off a bit, so that to me says we should be able to expand a little bit more. I think. It's all the commercial stuff that's causing the problems. Do I want a little bit more elementary school capacity? Oh, let me turn off road anarchy. See if that helps a bit. Because our percent of highly educated's dropped quite substantially. Alrighty. I mean, it's just education in general, isn't it? Like, I've only got one elementary school there. Do I have high schools? I've got high schools. Alrighty. So let's build some of these roads out, shall we? It's actually starting to look more like a grid the more I do this down here. I'm not sure if that's necessarily a good thing. Looks a little bit funky, doesn't it? It's almost like a spider web. Okay, that's that. These roads are so wonky. I don't know. I mean, I'm probably going to hate it, but I don't mind it. Gives it a bit of character. Like, look at this. Ooh. Looks like someone sneezed, Bob. Is that gritty enough? That's a weird bit there, isn't it? Alrighty, let me fill in these bits. In fact, I think I'll put some offices in here, you know. Just as a buffer to this. Really rowdy commercial area. Hello, Rostastika! I don't know why I said it like that. Welcome to the stream. Thanks for dropping by. You only just got my live notification just now. Yeah, I'm not very good at this, am I? I should really probably put a tweet out saying, hey, you, I'm streaming. If anyone wants to come and say hello, but... no, I am very poor at notifying people when I'm going live. But thank you for dropping by, nonetheless. Really appreciate you coming. How are you doing today, kind sir? Oh yeah, I need to do water, don't I? Doing alright on World of Warcraft a minute. The grind is real. The grind is real. When's the new expansion coming out? Do you know? I don't. I could easily research it myself, but you have a new Google when it comes to WoW, my friend. Interesting couple of days, actually, as far as things like video games are concerned. But there's been a few things going on that I wasn't really aware of. Like, you've got movie trailers being dropped left, right, and center. I imagine to get in before the November season. But also, I didn't even know that Disney was doing an expo. What was it? D23 or something? But like, a load of Disney trailers dropped. Marvel, The New Little Mermaid. Loads of stuff dropping. Leveling your monk and mount grinding for... a mount grinding sun, but... Eh! Time and effort. No one has time and or effort these days. He says while he's grinding his city to... 75,000 people living in it, which is time and effort. There we go. Alright, let's get to painting. I need to keep an eye on my sewage, water, and electricity. Electricity, not so much, but my sewage and water as I'm doing this. this should stave off any residential demand for the foreseeable future. Wait, why have we dropped back below 70,000? I was on like 71 at one point. I was so close. Come back. Come live in my city. Does it depend on how much traffic I'm letting through my city or something? I mean, I could build an airport if I wanted to. I don't know how that helps me though. In the grand scheme of things. What class monk are you being, Raz? You being the tank, you are you being brewmaster? There you go, buy new land. You can't tell me what to do, game. Although I should probably listen to it. I'm tentative to put any more commercial in because it keeps dying on itself. Like, more commercial isn't necessarily going to get me more commercial. There we go. We'll let that figure itself out. Buy new land. I don't know which one I want to buy. I'll buy one which is just a water block. Just did a painful dungeon mod. Which dungeon was it? Was it one I know? There's not a lot that I do know. With a group that couldn't do more DPS than me and didn't do boss tactics. Ooh, oh, Necrotic Wake. Which one's Necrotic Wake now? Is it that one where you go down and fight the tentacly monster? Or the lady with the tentacle pit? As the last boss. The first one in Kyrian. Oh, the first dungeon I ever did in Battle for Azeroth. Yeah, the one where the big floating necropolis comes and levels an entire area. And then you fight the guy at the top that blasts you with icicles. Shadowlands, yeah, that's... Battle for Azeroth and Shadowlands are such a blur. You know, to an extent, sometimes I feel like what happened in Battle for Azeroth, you know? I don't really remember. Yeah, you went to Kul Tiras and... Kul Tiras? And... Zul'Dazar. Zul'Dazar, wasn't it, Battle for Azeroth? Bloody hell. I'm getting old, man. It's like watching an old computer turn on, isn't it? Do you just hear that broadband sound effect in my brain? Rip me, I'll just pick this one, why not? Oh boy. Can't get the staff these days. Not enough industry. Maybe I should make this a big office district. I just really need to let this go, I think, Eric. I literally just let it keep expanding, but my population has declined so much. don't really know what's caused the population decline. How's my traffic? Still good. Yeah, 15 out of 19. How are we doing? Educate more citizens. It's because I leveled all this earlier and it's all pretty new. I'm slowly making my way through high school. Alrighty, well, I guess I just need to leave this to churn away for a little bit. Righty. What do I want to do then, since I'm not really... I'm just watching people leave my city. It's because everyone's so undereducated in... Everyone in this... on the west side of the city... this side, it's because they're so uneducated they can't work in the commercial district. Just causing my population to plummet. Do I have any charts I can look at? Maybe figure out sewage treatment. Make sure I've got an abundance of it. There we go. A few more water towers. That's sorted. Alrighty. I kind of wish it had this thing here. It said like, "What? Why it's dropping so much?" I know with this game that it's not all about zoning, which is how you get your population up. But there has to be a more astute reason why it drops so much. Is it lack of industry? I've pumped in some offices. This all become offices. And these. Just filling up every nook and cranny now with offices. Look at how much we've built. Look at how much we've built. This city's huge. How much time do we have left? 20 to 10. See, the problem I've got now is I'm kind of just expanding here. I've done everything I want to do beyond just continuously painting this with RCI zoning and micromanaging all this stuff and expanding this industry area. Like, it... I'm kind of at this juncture where I'm like, well, what do I do here? Do I have another 3-hour stream? as City Skylines, where we just painfully watch the population counter collapsing on itself. I'm so frustrated that it's done that, right? By all accounts, it doesn't make any sense. It's probably because Poopy Bay's no more. Like, the only reason people came to this city is because they wanted to live next to a cesspool. I don't blame them. It was a very famous cesspool. I just wish there was a... Do we have charts or something? Let's have a look. Power. Power's not a problem. Water's not a problem. Maybe if I top up my capacity for education. Okay, that's semi yellow. High school's way high. Does that invite anyone else in? No. Happiness. Residential happiness is fantastic. Good. Healthcare. Good. Good. Childcare and elder care is not a problem. Levels. I mean, we've even got high density residential here. With a lot of highly educated people in here. Wind. No problems. Traffic, no problems. Pollution. Pollution here and there. Noise complaints. None to speak of. Fire safety's good. Not a lot of coverage down here, mind. Lol. Maybe we need more. Another bus route might help. So I'll add bus route. Create a new line. And we'll bring it down here. See if it's improved things. I do remember reading a lot on the old interwebs that having decent transit coverage does help your population growth. Right, I'm gonna name this one. N Center. I mean, it's not even southwest at this point. What do I want to call it? Shywood Circular Place. Hey, you know exactly what I'm going to do next. Counterclockwise. There we go. I'm gonna name this one. Triwood, circular, counterclockwise. There we go. Painting the rest of that commercial. Okay, it did seem to help a little bit, having the better transport connections. I mean, I should probably build a train line through here, I imagine. Like an overland train line hooks up to there, it comes through here. I don't know, I don't want to demolish too much. That was kind of a problem. It is transit. Could probably build another railway station around here somewhere, I suppose. No, it starts plummeting again. Alrighty, okay, well, I am. Honestly, I don't really know where I go from here. I could keep doing this. I think you could honestly keep building stuff in City Skylines for a complete eternity. But the problem is, I want to move on to something else now. I'm so pleased with what we've done here. Remember where we first started? Just a grid layout here. And we said, we had ambitions at the start. We're going to have a nice high-rise tower over there. We're going to have all these nice skyscrapers. And we're going to try and maintain traffic. And I think everything I've said I wanted to do, I've kind of... Well, higher education's been a bit of a bummer at the end here. But I'm pleased with what we've done. And I don't want to labour the point anymore. I don't want to keep coming back to this every week and going... I'm going to get to 75,000 today and then not get to 75,000. Like, if I did this for another week, I think we would just be sat here just doing transit. I think we'd just be putting in railway lines and bus stations and stuff, and I don't want to do that. I'm happy. We've done as little projects. We've done as industry area, as little village up here. So... I think this is where I'm going to end the city of Yorkshire Vale for now. I mean, I'm sure there's definitely scope for improvement with this city. I think I would love to see what would happen if City Planner Players got a hold of this and just watch him tear it to pieces. he'll probably figure out exactly what's causing these problems down here straight away. But for now, that's me done with Yorkshire Vale, I think. I want to move on to something else, like, I don't know, no more heroes? That's been on the back of my mind for a lot, for maybe the Dolphin emulator, so I'll see if I can get that working, and I might do a few live streams of that, see how it goes, eh? But yes, Yorkshire Vale, we should all be very pleased with how this turned out, I think. I think we've done very well indeed. Now that Her Majesty the Queen has passed away, will the British National Anthem be changed? It will indeed. It will not be changed extremely so, but it'll just be God Save the King instead of God Save the Queen. And obviously where we say stuff like Send Her Victorious, it'll be Send Him Victorious. Not a major change with the National Anthem, just the wording around the... gender-specific words. So it'll just become God Save the King instead of God Save the Queen. But yes, that's it from me. And that's it from all us at Yorkshire Vale. So, yes. I'm going to save this. We're going to save this as Yorkshire Vale Season 1. Well, teaser Season 2. I don't know, man. I mean, we could have done so much stuff down here, but I just don't want to continue. I don't want to leave at the point with it. I don't want to come back next week and just stare at these meters at the bottom. I think we've done. So yes, that's gonna be it for that, and that's gonna be it for the stream as well. So tune in next week. Hopefully, I'll be streaming next week. We'll be starting some No More Heroes. I hope, if not, something else. I love leaving it vague. But yes, thank you so much for joining me today and in the previous streams as well. I really appreciate your time watching me bumble my way through these video games. But yes, thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you all in the next stream.